Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I would like to talk about something called Windows Terminal. Windows Terminal is basically an app provided by Microsoft, which is a mixture of all the terminals. Like it has Windows PowerShell, it has the classic command prompt, you can run your wsl2 virtual machines such as Ubuntu or Kali Linux on that. You can run your Google Cloud Shell instances on that and remotely access through via SSH, and there's absolutely anything you can do with that. Like you can customize it with your own needs, anything, colors, any app you want to run. So I would show you to do that. First of all, I will open my Windows Terminal. Yes, so now I have here the my PowerShell, so I can type ls and I have all the files which are there. I can remove that and I can go there and say command prompt. So it will open command prompt and it's tab like structure, and if I type here now ls won't work because it's a Linux command, so I'll have to do dir, and basically it will return the same, it will show me the same file structure which was there in the PowerShell here, like that. Yes. The other thing is I talked about customization, and I've created here Windows PowerShell custom. If I run that, it has a custom image and I can run wherever I want. Like if I type ls, it shows where I am and how which files are there. It's the C directory, like that. The next thing I wanted to talk about is the customization part. Right now we can see here I have a Windows PowerShell custom. You can notice that it has a custom icon, a custom background image, and I can basically run my C directory and any directory I want. If I type ls, I get all the contents in the C directory. The other thing was that I can run Ubuntu and Kali Linux. Ubuntu I can run through this. So basically I'm running a PowerShell, a command prompt, a custom PowerShell, and my Linux. So I can go to my root directory and here I am. I can cd home, then cd into my folder, and here I have my Ubuntu. Next is Kali Linux. I can access that as well. It's simple. Yeah, I can go to my root directory, I type ls, I can go home, ls, I can into my folder, there's nothing. So this is Kali Linux, Ubuntu, PowerShell custom, command prompt, PowerShell. It's a beast. And I can even run Azure. For that I have to make a tenant in my Azure Cloud Shell, and then I can access that as well. So yes, and the next thing I wanted to show was that to SSH into Google Cloud Shell. Notice, you can notice that I have a custom image here as well, a custom icon, and it will log in to my account which I have provided earlier. Yes, now it's done. Now it is verifiable. I have my Sherlock tool in my cloud, and which we can verify through here. I can go in my Chrome. I can type and once I am in my Cloud Shell machine, we can see that this exact same thing is there as well. So it's verifiable. Okay. Now, the next part is the customization part. So for customization, we can go to settings and open the JSON file. The JSON file has all the settings we need. Like we can see that through. We can see the command copy, the key has to be control plus C, then we can copy anything, and for pasting we can type control V, for find we can go to control shift F and all that. So if you know JSON, then you can write this pretty easily. So it's just, and everything is provided in the provided in the documentation. So I have used background image as an image, and is the same PowerShell, and I have named it something else, and I have provided an icon for it. Yes, now I have provided a background image, I have centered it, the opacity, the color scheme. I can even remove the color scheme because it's default, and this is a command wsl, and the file we have, I have created a shell script with a name set gcloud environment, and I can pass my email address and the project name I want to access, and then it will access that, and the icon and the name which was shown there. And then this is for the virtual the VMs which I'm running in my WSL2, and this is the schema for colors like Campbell PowerShell and all that. Thank you for watching.